Hello, and thank you for joining me on another episode of Legal Tuesdays. I am Monica Miller, the Legal Director and Senior Counsel here at the American Humanist Association, and on this series, I answer your questions about separation of church and state that you've asked for us on our social media platforms, sometimes through my social media platforms, perfectly okay. The ideal way is through our Facebook or through our online complaint form. The question I'll take this week comes from our online complaint form, but any method is fine. You'll also see that I'm not in my typical office. The weather has been really lovely out, and there's a lot of folks and children out right now with dogs and having a good time. So I don't, it's a little distracting while I'm recording, but I have my RVG background in this room, so somewhat befitting. The question is, let's see, I'm trying to use my phone less. I'm taking some yoga classes, and the teacher keeps emphasizing that like we look down at our phones a lot, and so I'm trying to get out of that habit and look outward. So bear with me, I'm just gonna open my email from here. Okay, so any way to publicize the amendment that separates church and state like the Second Amendment does? This is a really good question. We all kind of know what the Second Amendment is and does, but a lot of folks, even lawyers, are not familiar with the Establishment Clause of the First Amendment. Any way we can publicize it, I mean, that is our goal at the American Humanist Association. Not our one goal, we've got plenty of goals, but we certainly hope and strive to educate folks about their rights, and that's actually one of the aims of this particular series is education. We really encourage folks to get involved at their local political level. You've got a lot of folks at those local levels because I've watched a ton of city council meetings and town council meetings throughout the country for different types of litigation that we've done. And I can say just during those public comment periods, folks come from out of left field, right field, all the fields to talk about gun rights, and usually in favor of them when you're in these rural areas. Do the same for the First Amendment. Show up to your local governments. Help us spread the word about the First Amendment. Now, let's look into why that is. We don't have an NRA. The separating church and state. So the amendment that separates church and state, let's just back up for a second. That's the First Amendment. No one's expected to know that, but I hope that we get to that place because it comes before the Second Amendment, which I'm pretty sure even fifth graders could tell you what the Second Amendment is, maybe not, but I feel like it's quite popularized. And interestingly, it too does not say, you have the right to a machine gun any more than the First Amendment doesn't actually say, separation of church and state. It says Congress shall make no law respecting an establishment of religion or prohibiting the free exercise thereof. And so that we call the Establishment Clause. So part of our opposition is simply getting folks to understand that the Establishment Clause even means separation of church and state. We had a Supreme Court justice, Justice Gorsuch, in a recent oral argument in the United States Supreme Court. Can't emphasize that enough. The late RBG would be very disappointed about this. Referred to it as the so-called Establishment Clause, as if we don't even have, it's up for debate whether we have this amendment at all. It's not up for debate. It's the first of our Bill of Rights, and it comes before the right to bear arms, and the right to bear arms really has very little practical reasons for existing in today's society, unlike the First Amendment, which is the backbone, the structure, and what makes America great, what makes us unique, and what really kind of is essential for our democracy to survive. So, with that being said, we don't have a profit like the NRA, so we don't have an ability, or the gun manufacturers, we don't have an analog to that. So the best we have is lobbying, and so that's why I kind of was emphasizing going up to your local officials, helping us. If you have money to donate, we can certainly use that and direct it towards, really efficiently direct it towards the right legislative actions. We've got really, savvy folks working on the Hill for us and with us. And, Rachel's leading some awesome stuff with policy. and our free thought pack. So we've got just, there's a ton of ways to help if you're interested. But I wanted this question, I picked this question out because I thought it was so important to underscore that contrast between the two amendments, and that there is room, even though there's probably a limit compared to the Second Amendment with its competition or with its bottom line interests. But we still have the power of the fact that it is what makes America, you know, leaving the Church of England and the being penalized for praying to a different God than the one of the majority. It benefits everyone. So that's the end. Anything beyond this will just be a rant. But I look forward to talking to you on the next segment of Legal Tuesdays.